Hello all, welcome to the new video of Signals and Systems. In this video, we'll study about different types of controllers which are used in control system. Okay, so let's begin. So there are various types of controllers which are used in control system. So which are used in control system blocks to enhance the performance. Okay, so let's list out different types of controllers one by one and let's study the advantages and disadvantages of the same. Okay, so the first one is proportional controller. Okay, so the transfer function of proportional controller is Kp. Okay, so this simple transfer function, as you can see, Gc of s is equal to Kp. This is nothing but gain. Okay, so any amplifier with certain gain can act as proportional controller. So it is used to, what are the advantages? Let's write it down. So it is used to vary the transient response of the system. Okay, to vary the transient response of any control system. So based on the value of Kp, you will get different types of transient response for the given control system block. Okay, so this is the first type of controller, which is proportional controller. This is Gc of s is equal to Kp. So you can design any amplifier, so that will act as proportional controller. Okay, so the next type of controller is derivative controller. Okay, so the transfer function of derivative controller is Gc of s, so C stands for controller, is equal to Kd into s. Okay, so we had proportional controller just Kp. So for derivative controller, we have a gain Kd along with the parameter s. So hence the name derivative controller. Okay, this is in S domain. So the advantages of derivative controller is it is used to increase the stability of the system. To increase stability of any system, of any control system. So as you can see, S is in the numerator. Okay, so for any control system block, if the derivative controller is added in conjunction to the any control system block, so the overall transfer function will have one extra zero. Okay, so stability of any system is increased by adding zeros. Okay, so overall it increases the stability of control system. And also, since we are adding zero here, the steady state error will also increase. So that will come as disadvantage. Okay, so disadvantage being steady state error of control system block increases. Okay, So this is about derivative controller. Let's see the next type of controller. So the another type of controller which is typically used in control system is called as integral controller. So the transfer function of integral controller looks like this. Okay, so this is KI some gain upon S. Okay, so the advantages is it is used to decrease the steady state error. Okay, steady state error of control system block. So as you can see, by adding another S, we are decreasing the steady state error of the overall block. So that is the advantages. So disadvantage is the stability of the overall block decreases. So this is just opposite to derivative controller. So derivative and integral controller are just opposite. So steady stability of a control system decreases with the use of integral controller. Okay, so we had proportional controller, derivative controller and integral controller. So using these three, there may be combination. So one such combination is proportional controller plus integral controller. Okay, so this is one type of controller which is combination of proportional and integral. So the transfer function will be GC of S is equal to that was KP plus KI upon S. So just we need to add that both transfer function. Okay, so KP plus KI upon S. So this becomes S into KP plus KI upon S. Okay, this is the transfer function of proportional and integral controller. So this is used to decrease the steady state error without affecting stability. Okay, this is used to let me write the advantage again. So it is used to decrease the steady state error, decrease steady state error without affecting the stability. Because a pole and zero is added at the origin, so which will nullify. Okay, and overall it will decrease the steady state error. So what are the effects of PI controller? Let's see that. So the type of the system is increases, hence the steady state error decreases. Okay, so whenever there is a decrease in steady state error, you can assume that the type of the system has increased. Okay, so any block which will decrease the steady state error effectively increases the type of the control system block. So it also improves damping and reduces maximum overshoot, and also it filters out high frequency noise. Okay, so it basically acts as low pass filter. So this is a little bit about proportional plus integral controller. So main thing you need to know is it decreases steady state error without affecting the stability. Okay, so the another type of controller is proportional plus derivative. So the three fundamentals are proportional controller and derivative controller and integral controller. So rest everything is combination of first three. Okay, So similarly, this is proportional plus derivative. So the transform function, you can write it as, this is kp and this is kd into s. So this is added, okay, in if you have a control system block, so this pd is added here, which has transform function kp plus kd into s. Okay, so this is used to increase the stability without affecting the steady state error. Okay, because the type of the system is not changed. Okay, as you can see here, this is your transfer system control system block. So this is G of S and this is GC of S. So this is C of S and this is R of S. Okay, so it has some transfer function. Okay, and you are adding this kp plus kd into s. So this comes in the numerator of this transfer function. See, I have g of s as 1 upon s into s plus 1. So you are adding kp plus kd into s. So the type of the system remains same. Hence the steady state error of the control system block will not be changed. Okay, but since we are adding zero, extra zero to the control system block, the stability of the overall block increases. Okay, so this is used to increase the stability of this, otherwise it would be unstable. Okay, so think in that way. So it is used to increase the stability without affecting the steady state error. And proportional integral controller, what it was, so PI controller was just opposite. So you added, so it was S kp plus ki upon s. So suppose, say, in PI controller, the g of s, that is our control system which we are basically interested to improve the performance of that block we are interested. Okay, so we add integral controller, proportional integral controller. At that time, what happens? There will be 1 upon s into s plus 1. So you add this transfer function block. Okay, so the type of the system is increased now. Okay, so hence the steady state error will differ. So the steady state error decreases because we are playing with the type of the control system. Okay, so this is a bit about proportional plus derivative controller. So just don't go in depth, so just know the basics, what it is used and what it will do. So since we had two combinations, the final one is proportional plus derivative plus integral controller. So this is very famous kind of controller. So you must have seen the name PID everywhere, PID controller. So this is nothing but proportional plus derivative plus integral. So the transfer function is kp plus kd into s plus ki upon s. Okay, so you simplify it, you get kd into s square plus kp into s plus ki upon s. Okay, so it is used to decrease the steady state error. Why? Because we are adding extra pole, so it will decrease the steady state error. When you see, whenever we are adding a pole, we are decreasing the steady state error of the control system block. So this is an external block which we are appending to the existing block. So by adding this in conjunction with the existing block, we are introducing extra pole. It means we are reducing the steady state error. Okay, that is point number one. And also it is used to this controller, that is PID controller, increases the stability. Okay, so you can see pole is added at the origin and two zeros are added at the origin as well. So one pole will compensate with one zero, okay, and another zero will increases the stability. So this is the use of proportional plus derivative plus integral controller. So just know the differences. So if you want, if you have a control system block which lacks in both steady state error and stability, then you need to think of introducing a PID controller in your block. So that will increases the steady state error. It will decreases the steady state error and also increases the stability. Okay, so whichever is lacking in your control system block, you need to think of introducing any of this controllers, okay, in conjunction with the your existing block. So let me take few examples so that you'll be clear. So you need to know which type of controller you need to use. So let's see some examples now. So let's see a simple one mark question which was asked in gate 97, okay, in electrical engineering question paper. So the question is introduction of integral action in the forward path of unity feedback system results in. So there are four options. First option is system with good stability and improved steady state error, system with less steady state error, system with increased stability margin, system with better speed of response. So just now we studied different type of controllers. So whenever we see integral action, we should think of integral controller. So the integral controller had transfer function GC of S equal to KI upon S. So S is nothing but pole. So introduction of pole to any control system will increases the type of the control system. So increasing the type will reduce the steady state error. So out of these four options, we have system with less steady state error. So it is talking about decrease in steady state error with the introduction of integral controller. So the right answer is B. Okay. So this is how you can use the concept of different type of controllers in answering these questions. Otherwise it will not be possible for you to answer these simple one mark questions. Okay, so just make a chart of different type of controllers and add a column regarding stability and steady state error and speed of response, and just see and match the different type of controllers and write down the stability and steady state error, whether it increases or decreases. Okay, so in that way you can remember it in any of this answering these simple one mark questions. Okay, so thanks for watching the video, guys. If you want us to make any more videos on control system, please use the comment section. Thank you.